to be somebody. Yeah. Amen. So why should you pray to Mary? Shamama. When the son is greater than the mother. When the mother got to come to the son. And had to wait just like everybody else. She was a part of the 120. That was waiting on the Holy Ghost. Glory be to God. So she need power herself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She need power. And she need to wait to receive the power from her son.
Amen.
Who's Jesus. So every believer born again, washed. My God, you need the power of the Holy Ghost. That's why we ain't seen no demonstration in the church.
Yes.
The dead ain't raising. Cancer ain't going nowhere. Folks is dying with sickness. When the church said we ought to have power and folks dying prematurely. Where's the power in the church? We have a revival after revival, but we ain't demonstrating the power and the power. Because when you demonstrate the power, let it life change. Folks come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Signs and wonders will operate in the church. It's to demonstrate the power of God. Amen. Stop saying I got the Holy Ghost. You got the Holy Ghost. What you doing with it? What you doing with it? When God give the children, amen, when God give his disciples the Holy Ghost, 120, the Holy Ghost. When you go and you study after that, oh God, you see signs and wonders. Every time they preach, Jesus show up. Every time, every miracle start to happen.
Amen.
And it was the demonstration of the power of the Holy Ghost that is working in them. So don't get comfortable and say, oh, everything was right. Everything ain't all right until you get filled with the Holy Ghost and with power.
Come on.
Come on, somebody. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Yes, you need the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Hallelujah. My brother, my sister, if you don't have the Holy Ghost, you need the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You can't do nothing. You'll not be effective without the Holy Ghost. You'll have no power without the Holy Ghost. You'll not be able to be stable in the things of God without the Holy Ghost. Unless you want to be wishy-washy, you ain't need the Holy Ghost. You can do that by yourself. But if you want to be firm in the things of God, you've got to have all of God living inside of you. And what happened? They speak in tongues. As the Spirit give them utterance, right? Read.
Yes.
We're going to engage with
it. And some upon each of them.
Every one of them.
And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost.
You hear that? Hold it right now. Underline that word filled. They didn't have a touch of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
See, a touch don't last, you know. You can touch him with the word. Then it goes. But they was filled with the Holy Ghost. That means the Holy Ghost came in and take up residence in them and filled them with power. You can't have it this much. It ain't good enough. You can't have it this much. It ain't good enough. You can't have it this one. Oh, I almost there. Almost there ain't good enough. You gotta be filled with it. You gotta be filled with the power of God. See, when you're filled with the power of God, you know what happens? Anytime a person is filled with the power of God will start, amen, manifesting on the outside. When you're filled with something, it starts manifesting, folks start to see it on the outside. Say, my God, what's this? What's this? What's this? What's this? You open up your mouth and they see it. Do you know when a believer has been filled with an anointing, when they open their mouth and start to preach or teach, the power of God, a person can literally sense the power of God.
My Lord Jesus.
And that comes out of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That comes out of the Holy Ghost. They've been telling me, some of the church folks, they've been telling you, when you get saved, you'll receive the Holy Spirit and everything is all right. Oh, no. If you ain't no evidence in speaking in tongues, my God, yes, we have the tarry for you. We have to pray and tell the Holy Ghost, come on you. And there got to be some evidence that you got the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. There got to be some evidence. My God. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, you're jumping, shouting, and dreaming. But after you're jumping and shouting, there need to be some evidence coming out of you. Because when they get filled with the Holy Ghost, the first evidence was they begin to speak in tongues as the Spirit gives them utterance. Shama, the power of the Holy Ghost ought to abide in the church. But it can't come in the church when you don't want it. It can't come in you when you don't want it. You done ready to decide, I done ready got it. I got the Holy Spirit from the time I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Okay, you got the Holy Spirit from the time you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. What you do with the Holy Ghost? How much souls you win for the kingdom of God? Do you know the soldiers and the disciples that begin to win souls after it was filled with the Holy Ghost? Why, Pastor? Let me tell you. These souls, amen, was under the influence of the power of this ear, of this ages. That means it was under the influence of the power of the devil. So now, in order to overcome and bring them to God, they need to have the people, whoever can win them, need to have in them a higher power than the power of darkness.
Amen.
When you witness to somebody that is in the world, would you think what kind of spirit is operating around that person? The spirit of this world.
Amen.
So in order for you to convince them, you need to have the Holy Ghost in you. Because it's going to take a power to undo a power.
Amen.
A higher power undo a power.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. And this is what the church needs. The church, we need to stop talking about it and there's some action.
Yes.
Because the church in the book of Acts, they had action.
Yes.
My God, I say they had action. My sister, they had so much action. And then Peter himself, his shadow, his very shadow. My God. He did the man of God, filled with the Holy Ghost. They didn't have to speak a word. And this war, and his very shadow hit the people, and the people was healed. There's no way that you can do that without the Holy Ghost. So the church needs the Holy Ghost. You can't live right without the Holy Ghost. You can't talk right. You can't love right without the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. You can't love well. You will not even have a right walk with God without the Holy Ghost. So the church need the Holy Ghost. Everybody need the Holy Ghost. If you want to represent Jesus Christ, your only way you're going to be effective in representing Him is with His Spirit. You've got to have His Spirit inside of you. Glory be to God. And they begin to speak in tongues as the Spirit of God give them utterance. And listen here. Amen. The evidence now, knowing that they speak in tongues, amen, there was witness that there was people on the outside that heard them talk in a language. And they know there's no way these people should be able to talk in this language. And they didn't even know that language. Come on, somebody. Amen. So it got to be a supernatural power invade inside of them and now give them the capability to talk, to speak in tongue, because tongue is language.
Amen.
It's speaking in another language. Demon get afraid, devil start to tremble when you talk about the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
When you're talking about the mission of the church and what the church need to be doing, the devil don't like it, because the devil doesn't like a church that are strong and established in the truth.
Amen.
He doesn't mind you know part of the truth. But part of the truth ain't gonna set you free.
Amen.
The Bible says you shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free.
Amen.
It's gonna take all of Him to make you free.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And we're gonna see great things and signs and wonders. And amen. And not like the book of Acts, greater than the book of Acts. Because you remember Jesus said, greater works we shall do than these.
Amen.
So the greater works, the only way you can do those greater works is through the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
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 Through the power of the Holy Ghost. You got to be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. You got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Now, yes, we can begin to journey some scriptures, and then, amen, as I begin to... Amen. You know, a good lawyer win case. by evidence. Amen. So I got to present evidence. Amen. Amen. The Bible says you shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free. So I have to reveal the truth to you.
Amen.
Not what I think, but what he said.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. I'm going by what I think. I'm going by what he said. 2:46. Acts chapter 10, verse 44. 46. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. My God. Amen. The devil ain't gonna have a chance. I said the devil ain't gonna have a chance. Let's stop in verse 44.
While Phineas had these words, the Holy Ghost fell on them.
You hear that?
Which heard the word.
You hear that? You see? So the Holy Ghost comes and responds of the word. The Holy Ghost comes and responds of the word. When they preach the word, the Holy Ghost came and responded of the word. Now what happened?
And they of the circumcision, which believed were astonished.
Go ahead.
As Manas came with fear,
because
that the Gentiles also were poured out.
You see, now, watch it now. The Gentiles now was being filled with the Holy Ghost. The Gentiles now was filled with the Holy Ghost. Not just the Jews, but also the Gentiles were filled with the Holy Ghost.
My Lord.
And they was in astonishment because they used to just the Jews, and the Jews filled with the Holy Ghost. But now the Gentile is filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor you need the Holy Ghost.
You need the Holy Ghost.
Say, don't fool yourself. You need the Holy Ghost.
You need the Holy Ghost.
You need the Holy Ghost. I am a master. I can show you. Amen. I sing to God. And for y'all who want the Holy Ghost, amen, I can pray after this prayer. Amen. And let me tell you something. I can pray this prayer after it gets through. I can say prayer in your faith. Your faith. You will receive the Holy Ghost. Through your faith,
amen,
you will receive the Holy Ghost. Amen. He says that the word was preaching. And so I'm preaching the word.
Amen.
The word is the foundation. The Bible says that if the foundation be destroyed, which shall the righteous do? You can build a house and first you lay the foundation. Amen. So now, he's telling us that the Holy Ghost is given also to the Gentile, not just the Jew. You remember in Joel 2? Amen. The prophet Joel says, in the last days, says God, I will pour my spirit upon all, and sons and daughters shall walk. Amen. So, this is the fulfillment of the prophecy of Joel. Amen. Go ahead and read.
For they heard them speak with tongues.
Yeah, they what?
They heard them speak with tongues.
They what?
Unmagnified.
They heard them speak with what?
With tongues.
So when the Holy Ghost came on them, what they heard? What they heard? No, they heard some noise. No, they heard them crying and shouting. So how did they know that they were filled with the Holy Ghost?
They
heard them what? Okay. So how you know when you're filled with the Holy Ghost? How you gonna know it? Things of God don't change. God never changed. The same way God did it yesterday, he's doing it even today. The same way, don't change. Don't change. Amen? It never changes. Because a lot of times, because of our head knowledge, because of a lot of our head knowledge, we try to figure out who God is. We are trying to figure God or produce God according to our head knowledge. No. It's going to take your faith. Look at your neighbor. I say neighbor.
God
is the same.
God is the same.
Yesterday.
Today.
And forever.
If
he filled with the Holy Ghost, if he filled him with the Holy Ghost yesterday, he's going to do it today.
Amen.
If he filled him with the Holy Ghost yesterday, he's going to do it today. And he's going to do it now.
Amen.
Amen. The church that's trying to, yes, amen. They want nothing to do with the Holy Ghost in the church. That's why we have a lot of stuff going wrong in the church. Because we're pushing out the Holy Ghost. You hear what I mean? Holy Ghost. God's going to help you live holy.
Amen.
You can't live holy without the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So we do everything because we don't want no part of the Holy Ghost in the church. We want no part of the Holy Ghost in the church. Now we're trying to run church and run ministry without the Holy Ghost. God help them. I said only God can help them. They really don't realize what they're dealing with. They don't know what they're dealing with. They don't know what kind of fight you are in. And this fight